In London during March of 1934 was seen the greatest display of any one metal ever staged. By the close cooperation between the Daily Mail and the company, the public was able fully to appreciate the decorative and labour-saving value of rustless steel. The exhibition has always been noted for providing the most up-to-date ideas in the construction and furnishing of the home. This year it contained in addition Staybrite City. From London itself, from the suburbs and from the provinces, people flocked to the ideal homes exhibition at Olympia. The huge central hall of Olympia was turned for the occasion into a palace of glittering steel. Close inside the main entrance, the central aisle was spanned by a great arch, beautifully proportioned and growing up from the field of stands clustered about its base. Then from this arch, towering away up into the roof of the building, was a pencil of Staybrite tubes which, cunningly lighted, glistened at night almost like threads of finely spun glass. See the reflection of the tower in a polished witchbowl. Looking back towards the door through which one had entered, the end of the hall was seen to be sheathed in sheets of rustless steel, a striking transformation which gave a glimpse into the future, when we may see in place of the crude painted ironwork and ornamental stone of earlier buildings, the clean hard lines of concrete relieved with glass and polished steel. The frieze is composed of Staybrite sheets, alternately polished to a highly reflecting mirror or burnished to a dull satin finish. At the west end, a brilliantly polished canopy fell away to the terrace below. Now watch carefully. There is the canopy itself, and now you see its reflection in a sheet of Staybrite steel 100 feet below. This demonstrates in a striking way the really beautiful mirror finish which this material will take. Now take one last look across the hall and see the ceilings of the stands below and the stainless pillar striking up towards the roof. It was Mr. Jeffcott who conceived this colossal expression of modern simplicity and decoration. Here he is in his office during those busy months of preparation. In Staybrite Street were situated the stands of a number of firms manufacturing or handling Staybrite goods for domestic use. Here were exhibited Staybrite bathroom fittings and stainless steel furniture, stainless kitchen ranges, sinks, pots and pans, spoons and forks, and window fasteners, door handles, finger plates, and many more details than it is possible to recount. Actually, a catalogue was produced which named a number of these everyday necessities which are already in production in Staybrite steel. This list covered about 2,000 different items. At the end of Staybrite Street was situated the firm stand, which soon became the social centre of the exhibition. Staybrite is essentially a homogeneous alloy steel containing 18% of chromium and 8% of nickel, together with certain other alloys added in small quantities to modify the properties of the steel to suit special conditions of service. It is not just a surface plating, and its beauty is therefore more than skin deep. It is stainless through and through. Here are Dr. Hatfield, technical director, and Mr. Grant, managing director of the company. Here, a very interesting demonstration is in progress, which illustrates the essential acid-resisting properties of Staybrite as compared with mild carbon steel. A schoolboy has come up out of the crowd and is holding a test tube, into which is put some mild steel filings and nitric acid is poured onto them. The reaction is so violent as to cause the acid to froth up out of the mouth of the tube. Now watch it with Staybrite. Staybrite suffers no attack whatever, and is in fact used for the construction of storage and transport tanks employed in the manufacture of strong commercial nitric acid. This power to resist the corrosive attack of acids is the paramount property of Staybrite. In the home, it means that a kitchen tabletop may always be kept clean, with nothing more than a rub over. Kettles, pots, and pans do not become stained, and there is no coating of enamel to chip and flake off. All kitchen utensils can be kept clean with a minimum of labor. In other parts of the house, its use enables one to capture that spirit of simplicity which is the basis of modern decoration. Moreover, a Staybrite home is a labor-saving home. Staybrite may cost a little more initially, but it is practically everlasting, and it always pays in the long run to buy the best. Take one last look across Staybrite City, and then see the Staybrite swimming pool. This pool was completely lined with Staybrite, and satin-finished Staybrite sheets formed. At one corner, a fountain kept the water continually in circulation, whilst at the far end was a covered terrace providing shelter from the sun. Finally, before leaving, we must see Staybrite City by night. Domestic applications are by no means the only uses for Staybrite. And here, in our museum, is a wide selection of other articles manufactured from rustless steel. About the year 1914, Firth's 13% chromium cutlery quality of stainless steel was marketed. But it was not until 10 years later that the 18-8 Staybrite steel made its appearance. That is to say, Staybrite has been on the market only 11 years, and yet in that time has proved itself indispensable in such diverse applications as commercial architecture, domestic furnishing and equipment, and aircraft construction. As you look around this room, you will see an aeroplane propeller, a ship's ventilator, letters for shop fronts, aircraft fittings, motor car valves, and even a Staybrite bottle. Elsewhere are divets, steam jacketed pans, autoclaves, and other pieces of chemical and industrial plant. Passing reference has already been made to the chemical properties of Staybrite, and you may be interested to see a cylinder which has been immersed in strong nitric acid for several years and has suffered no attack. These three cylinders have been immersed in seawater since December 1924. The first, of mild steel, is almost disintegrated. The second, of 13% chromium stainless steel, has rusted slightly, whilst the third of Staybrite is as bright as on the day it was put in. This little model was cast in Staybrite, and quite a lot of non-corrosive steel was used in the construction of its prototype, the Supermarine Seaplane, which in 1931 won the Schneider Trophy outright for Great Britain. The plane has been launched prior to the race itself, and as she is towed out of the start, she makes a beautiful picture. Now she is getting underway, and after taxiing for a mile or more, she leaves the water. Watch the screen carefully. She will be flying at over 300 miles an hour, around the pylon, and away she goes on the last lap, whilst everyone crowds round the boards to learn the speed. Now Flight Lieutenant Boothman hurtles across the line to win the trophy outright for Great Britain at a speed of 340 miles per hour. Made by Mr. T.O.M. Sopwith to regain the America's Cup. Here you see the launch of Endeavour, the most perfect yacht ever built. A beautiful example of the art of boat building wedded to the science of aeronautics. The mast and its gear, although on the whole as light as in other racing yachts, is actually very considerably stronger, owing to the use of special high tensile steel bars for the standing rigging. Staybrite was used to advantage for the deck fittings and the hounds on the mast are special alloy steel forgings. Now she flashes into a short ocean swell and gradually works her way out to windward of her opponent. Big racing cutters, and many other things more common in our daily life, were once created by craftsmen solely from wood. And in yacht building, tradition dies hard. It is therefore a significant thought that even a racing cutter approaches as near perfection as ever before by the skillful and sympathetic use of steel in her construction. Finally, we come to the year 1935, which opened in London with the exhibition of British art in industry at the Royal Academy. At the top of the main staircase, these beautiful gates and turnstiles were erected, built in Staybrite steel to a design by Mr. Rico Cathy. They capture in a striking way the essential simplicity and severity of style, which is the spirit of the exhibition. The whole treatment shows how utilitarian things, designed with sympathy and knowledge of modern conditions, and executed in the most modern of all metals, may yet possess inherent beauty without destroying in the smallest degree the essential purpose of their existence.